conversations, hibernation and hallucinations. Such Stuff as Dreams is a love story featuring stringed instruments, armadillos and DIY furniture. It is a show for anyone who has ever felt or wanted to feel human connection. And we are joined now by director Adam Rowe and actors Tyler Wilson-Corkery and Catherine Yates. Welcome.
Yes, welcome Hello. To the cafe,
well,
guys.
Super intrigued me just with the description of it there. So Adam, we had you on the show actually a couple of months ago, didn't we, talking about your last production, which was Her.
Here. So I was acting that last production with Silo Theatre Company.
How did that go?
Amazing, man. It was my first time acting on, like, you know, big professional production, downtown Auckland show, and playing with names like Rima Tuira and Nathaniel Lees was just wild.
I bet.
Okay, this is stuff that Dreams are made of.
Yes, true. And the debut directing for this show. Mm-hmm. How has that been? Is there a difference that you've, you know, have you worked out a preference? Would you rather act or direct?
They're just really completely different processes.
Okay.
So I debuted with this show earlier in the year for its development season at the Poe Theatre. And since then I've directed one other show and then back to this one after the script's changed.
Oh, awesome. Nice.
I like zooming out and kind of holding the whole room and looking after everyone.
Right.
And piecing together a wider journey. But yeah, it's not anything like acting.
So let's talk a little bit about the actual show before we get into the characters and stuff. What is it about?
So it's a three-hander, meet cute, boy meets girl love story, but he has schizophrenia and the third actor plays all the voices inside of his head.
Oh, okay.
So the relationship between them is really interesting. It's kind of the voices play a jealous girlfriend, kind of, almost, trying to get in the middle. So yeah, that's a significant obstacle.
Where does the armadillo come in?
This guy.
A lot. Oh. So the armadillo is a part of Alfie's way of dealing with his schizophrenia. You see him deal with it in a variety of ways. He loves animal facts, and that's something that helps him a lot, and he likes to turn into an armadillo and roll around in a big ball.
Oh, nice. Okay, cool. So you, Tyler, play Alfie.
Yes, sir.
And Catherine, you play Claire. Tell us a bit more about Claire.
Claire, she didn't have so much of a bigger role in the development season, so she's really come in with a real kick this time. A lot of attitude, gives Alfie a bit of a hard time, but they're obviously made for each other.
Yeah. What does she do? What's her job?
She works at a cafe.
Yes.
She's studying hypnosis, is that right?
No.
Yeah, so in the original text, she was studying hypnosis, but I think
it's gone. It's gone. Yeah. I haven't heard that yet. Schizophrenia is obviously a big theme in the show. What sort of research did you all have to put into it?
So Daniel Goodwin played Morph originally. Morph is the voices character. He played Morph in the original production, and then he's worked with script development and dramaturgy and stuff, and he has schizophrenia himself and works in mental health, so he's been a keystone advisor for us to make sure we're not doing any boo-boos.
Yeah. And I would imagine that's a bit of pressure on you, Tyler, as well, you know, to capture the essence of someone with schizophrenia. You know, it must feel like there's a bit of pressure.
At first, I think there was. I think part of it is the fact that people with schizophrenia are very much like regular people, and then they're very much they just happen to have schizophrenia.
Right.
They just happen to have extra routines that they go through, and I think being able to learn about that through Dan has been a great experience.
And good for everyone else to learn about it.
Absolutely.
Through that character as well.
Mm. What's interesting too is that you talked about, we had the development of this earlier on this year, didn't we? Obviously a bit has changed since obviously waitress Claire is no longer into hypnosis. I mean, what else changed? Like when you do that development season, what changes from then to this?
In terms of the script, it's been, some bits have gotten chunked out and some bits have been completely cut because, you know, just like, there's a real refining and distilling process that happens with the script, and finding out major holes, like Catherine was saying, that Claire's character was kind of just like a sounding board for Alfie in the original, so she's got a lot more of her own stuff going on in this version.
Good,
fleshed out women characters on stage. What a novel concept.
Keep doing more of that.
Yeah, good. So we've got, you know, a romantic hero who's got schizophrenia, which is one diversity tick, but let's also have a fleshy lady character.
And Catherine, you know, when you're approaching this role, what's running through your mind? Is it a comedy? Is it, you know, how would you describe it to your friends?
Well, reading it, I was like, oh, it's not really comic, but because she's so angry. But when we've been rehearsing it, it's like, oh my God, this is actually hilarious just because of the situation that they're in and just some what he puts up with. It's just crazy. Yeah. But yeah, I'll just say it's a comedy now. It's quite comic.
Okay, nice.
So what does he put up with?
Lots of...
Well, go on, mate.
I mean, so they both put up with quite a lot of things. I think one of the things is that these are two people who society would say is a little bit weird, and they've found that their weirdness has a home, and that's in each other. And so, but there's a little bit of a journey to that. You need to figure out, oh, this person is actually kind of, there is kooks or quirks, and then you find out that you really enjoy those kooks and quirks, and then and then that intertwining.
That's love, right, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And life, really, isn't it? And what do you want people to get out of it, Adam, when they come along and they're leaving at the end of the night? What do you hope they've felt?
I really hope that people, that this is a little extra token towards people stopping apologising for their weirdness.
Mm. Cool. Yeah.
You know, like just dial it up. In fact, go hard, full throttle towards whatever it is that makes you happy, and don't apologise.
It sounds like the whole show was dialed up.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, sir.
One of your most, I guess, fun things that you've done?
This show?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a lot of fun all of the time. and this is just an extension of that.
Oh, awesome.
Hey, it sounds great, good. And you've really sold it really well, and it sounds like an ultimate love story, actually. Thank you all for joining us today. Such Stuff as Dreams plays at Auckland's Basement Theatre from tonight until Saturday. You can check out their website for ticket details.